Hello. In this video, we'll very quickly introduce data lineage in Google Cloud. Data lineage is most relevant and automated across services like Cloud Composer, BigQuery, Dataplex, and even Vertex AI for machine learning. If you use or have plans to use these cornerstone services, data lineage is something to be aware of. Ultimately, services like Cloud Composer, Vertex AI, and BigQuery are core workload services themselves and focused on more than just metadata like data lineage. Meanwhile, Dataplex is a bit different in that it's specifically focused on metadata and a data fabric layer that sits on top of other data sources like the ones we've highlighted here. Imagine for a moment that we have a BigQuery table and we're transforming it with BigQuery SQL commands and Cloud Composer operators to generate a more curated dataset. This is exactly where data lineage is most interesting and will apply. We'll be able to know when we look at that end curated data that it ultimately came from the processing of specific raw data and how that data was processed using BigQuery and Cloud Composer. We also have some options to do manual data lineage tracking in GCP and especially using Dataplex, but we'll be focusing on just a broad introduction to this topic and what the automatic data lineage features look like. Let's go ahead and start with Dataplex, that data fabric layer. In Dataplex, we see some lineage that we can surface from BigQuery. For example, maybe we have a dataset that synthesizes a couple of tables, and we'll see this in the lineage here. Our total green trips for 2022 and 2021 are ultimately processed using SQL from a couple of tables that were leveraged at specific points in time. We can also see this information in BigQuery itself. You may be familiar with the data lineage view, which we can access by clicking into the resource and then looking at the lineage tab. Even in resources as wide as Vertex AI, we do have some lineage tracking as well. This is important for things like MLOps, where we need to ensure that we're tracking how models are created and what datasets are feeding into machine learning assets. For example, we know that a Vertex AI dataset has been used in processing, and we can see where a test split for a specific model was generated. We could have large lineage graphs and traceability across different assets, and most of this is captured automatically, but you can also supplement that using Python code and manually creating lineage metadata. To get started with data lineage, even the no-work automatic lineage inference, you need to have a couple of APIs enabled. Notably, you'll need the Data Catalog API, which you can search for, and the Data Lineage API. Oftentimes, you'll also need the Dataplex API enabled. With those APIs enabled, you'll start to get automatic data lineage inference and the ability to manually add information about the data lineage for your assets. This complements other pieces of metadata that we have around tagging, data profiles, glossaries, and other unified metadata layers available in things like Dataplex. We hope this was a helpful, quick introduction to data lineage, and we'll watch the comment section for any questions. Thank you for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.